electrons and the conduction band. Okay. Now, what is valence band and what is conduction band? Valence band is when the electrons are in the 0 degree temperature, when the electrons are the major carrier in which band will be called as a valence band. Okay. Now, whenever we will start increasing the temperature, then the electrons will be start moving and they will be moved from valence band to conduction band. So, after temperature, the electrons will be in the conduction band, means the major carriers are will be in conduction band, and in 0 degree temperature, the electrons will be in valence band. Okay. Now, essentially, a band gap represents the minimum energy that is required to excite an electron up to the state in the conduction band, where it is the participant in conducting. When the electron charge will be moved towards the conduction band, then the electrons or the conduction band will participate to conduct or generate a proper band gap. Now, come to the experiment. For this experiment, we need an oven. This one is your oven. This is the oven. A thermometer, which is this. This one is a thermometer. And a reverse saturation kit. Okay, this is the kit where this one is your ammeter and this one is your voltmeter. The voltmeter will be in fixed condition, which will be at 0.2, and where the thermometer will be connected? Thermometer will be connected here. This is the oven. There is a hole, right? So, in the hole, we will connect a thermometer. So, we can measure the temperature. Okay? So, we can measure the temperature. According to the heat of this oven, the thermometer will be increase the temperature and we can measure the temperature. According to the temperature, we will measure the current. Okay, according to the temperature, we will measure the current. So, in this experiment, you will see when the temperature will be increased, when the temperature will be start increasing, your current will be start increasing. Okay, when the temperature will be start increasing, see, now the temperature is at 45 degrees. Okay, now the temperature is at near about 45 degree. According to this temperature, the current is 198. This one is 100, this is 200. So, this is increase in the increasing order in one division. So, it is at 198. So, I am writing this is the table for this experiment. This one is a table where you have to take the temperature. Now the temperature is at 45. At 45 degree temperature, the increasing current means the temperature is increasing. That's why it is increasing current. This is 198. Now, what we have to do? We have to wait for the increasing part. It will be increasing and you have to take the reading up to 90 degree temperature in 5-5 increasing order. Okay. So, after that, when it will be cross the 90 degree temperature, you have to stop the increasing part. Means, you have to switch off this oven. Okay. In this table, we have an increasing part for a temperature. We have a decreasing part for that temperature. Okay. So, first we have to take the reading from 45 to 90 degree, means 40, 50, like this up to 90 degree. You have to first take the increasing data up to 90. Then for the decreasing part, means the temperature will be start decreasing. So you have to take the reverse process. Okay. So we will start from 90 degree to 45 degree. Okay. Next come to the temperature in Kelvin. What we have to do, you have to just convert the degree centigrade temperature to the Kelvin temperature, means the temperature in degree centigrade plus 273. Okay, whatever the value is your Kelvin temperature value, then you have to calculate the inverse temperature, means one by T, where T is in capital. Whenever you will see a capital T always denote the Kelvin temperature. So we will take the Kelvin temperature here. Okay, 1 by Kelvin temperature. Next come to the ln I naught. What is ln I naught? I naught is basically a average value. So here we are not calculating the average value. So we will take the decreasing value. So now see, now the temperature is at 90 degree. Okay, at the 90 degree temperature, you can see the current is 298. Okay, now this is the increasing part. You have to take from 45 to 90 degree at the 5-5 increasing order. Here I am taking only the minimum and the maximum reading. So the minimum is the increase for 45, 198 is the increasing current. At the 90 degree temperature, the increasing current is 298 degree. Now what we have to do? We have to take the decreasing current. For the decreasing current, you have to switch off the oven. See, in this side the oven is on, and this side oven will be off. Okay, so I'm off, switch off the oven. Now you will see the temperature will be start decreasing. Okay, it will be very slow down process. So the temperature will be start decreasing. For decreasing part, you have to start from 90 degree to 45, means just reverse. So from 90 degree means when you will get the switch off the oven, the temperature will be same, right? So the temperature will be at 90 degree also. For the decreasing is 298. Okay, now it is decreased up to 85 degree temperature, right? So the current is, see, you can see the current is decreasing. For 85 degree temperature, the current is 250. So see, now the temperature is decreased, and now the temperature is at 45. At 45 degree temperature, at 45 degree temperature, now the current is near about 150. It is at 151. Okay, it is at 151. Now come to the part here. Whenever you will calculate this part, you will see all the readings are coming according to the range at 10 to the power minus 3. Now come to the graph. What you have to do? You have to plot a graph. In the x-axis, 1 by T, which is multiplied with 10 to the power minus 3. Okay. And the y-axis, ln I naught. Okay. Now, the graph nature comes like this. Okay. The graph nature comes like this. What you have to do? You have to plot a slope. Okay, you have to plot a slope. I'm putting the name A, B, C. Now what you have to do? You have to calculate the band gap. So how you have to calculate the band gap? So the formula is I naught is equal to C into e to the power minus eg divided by eta kt. So if we take the ln in the both side, then it will be ln I naught is equal to ln C. This will be simplified and it will become as minus Eg by eta kT, where Eg by eta k, this is the slope. Okay, this is the slope. Now the formula for band gap means Eg. Eg will be slope into k, where k is equal to Boltzmann constant, where the k is Boltzmann constant. Okay, so the Boltzmann constant value is 1.38 into 10 to the power minus 23 joule per Kelvin. Okay, so what we have to do? We have to because we are calculating the Eg, means band gap, the unit will be in electron volt, right? So we have to convert this Boltzmann constant into an electron volt charge. So you have to divide this total value with 1 electron volt charge, which is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. Okay, if you divide this Boltzmann constant value with this value, so the value will become as 8.6 into 10 to the power minus 5 in electron volt. Okay, now you have to just calculate it. Means your band gap is now Eg is equal to slope into 8.6 into 10 to the power minus 5 in electron volt, right? Here is your slope value, means m into 10 to the power 3 into 8.6 into 10 to the power minus 5 electron volt. So if we are simplifying this, then it will be 8.6 into m into 10 to the power 3 and 10 to the power minus 5 will be calculated, and it will be 10 to the power minus 2 electron volt. After calculating this, suppose we are getting the value A, then the value will be A into 10 to the power minus 2 electron volt. This one is your band gap. So this is the answer and this is your experiment. Thank you.